you know, you can't create a thought. You can't create yourself, so you let external environments, which are actually inside you, you let your other bodies create for you. Don't be upset if you can't create. Recognize that's a situation. Mm-hmm. And then you could, once you understand that, then you are forced to create. And that is a strange new adventure.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And that's what we've been recommending, like going to the airports, go create with the undead. You don't have to use any standards. So you cancel the aborted thought in your chip body, probably the TV body, and the astral body, and the chemical body. Mm-hmm. But then all four bodies are working, and you decide which one you want to invent. And that gets you into the mystery landscape.
Yes, it does. I want to say that the chip body in South America, it is in its infancy still, because it seems to me that the chemical body in the Peruvian area and in Panama is still more energy is associated with that. I don't see the acceleration, the discontinuity as much. It is happening. What is interesting is the electrocution of the younger generation of Peruvians that I saw that are already walking in the streets. It's funny to see this. They're walking in the streets with donkeys and animals and llamas in the middle of nowhere, talking on the phone. While they're walking their livestock, which is a whole other thing, and while traffic is honking and everything, it's already starting that their awareness level is being shifted. The whole type of transformation of the younger generation, the more electronically inclined people over there, I'm starting to see very small symptoms of what I see here in terms of people's awareness level of what's going on.
I would say that once they have their phones, they have the chip body. It doesn't expand. Once you have it, you're there. Your chemical body has been marginalized. Even though those people don't have a lot of TV landscape or the byproducts of the TV landscape, they are in the chip body, and that is a problem for the chemical body. Now, you said a lot of people there are worried about America. You said they're very astute, and they're up on America. Well, mm-hmm. America is the Android meme, the image of America. The focus on America is the Android meme. They are seduced by that. They are. If you're informed on what's going on in America, then you're uninformed. You're on the way to arriving at undead. Because you
right.
can't figure.
That's right. I like that.
Yeah, you can't. They are watching America, and they got their opinions, but they'll never be able to complete a thought about it. They'll just keep maybe getting better cell phones and iPhones and that, and they'll be doing it with seemingly faster. But they've already arrived in the chip body, and the chip body has landed on them, and it doesn't go anywhere. It's from there. So mm-hmm. it doesn't matter how good your chip body is, how up to date the latest app or anything. Once you have it, and you saw these people have it, they're in it. And they're probably worrying about America. That would be the TV landscape of their Android meme four-body structure. And mm-hmm. so how would you get them? I bet you would find it very difficult to get them not to be concerned about what they're watching in the United States. See, they believe that's there.
Yes, yes, they do. I saw all these different habitual behavioral differences over there with the chip body. They're vastly different because they're here. Everybody's in a rush because they've been accelerated for so long. They've been dealing with that chip over there. It
Let's
just seems like
let's not call it a rush. Let's not call it a rush, James. They're in a void. They can't complete a thought, so they're always trying to connect to someone else's created thought. It's
yeah.
like Brownian motion. Brownian in physics. It's just a resonating quantum fluctuations. That is what you're talking about. And even that now has happened so much in America that people like the undead situation.
Yeah, they get off on it now.
Yeah, that's right. And then they get off on it for so many years, then they want to go to a new experience and go into the mystery landscape, which is, I'm going to die. I'm going to transition into the gup. That's a great mystery. So part
exactly.
of the mystery... Part of the mystery landscape, which is affecting everybody in the world, everybody, is the phenomenon of the undead.
Mm-hmm.
And so you were interacting with the undead there. even though they don't have the highways and automobiles and all that stuff for the chemical body, they are in that same situation, and it's just like if you went outside to the local 7-Eleven or something, they would be concerned about the TV landscape and the Android meme, still hypnotized by it. Mm-hmm. And that's what Obama and everybody's running on, that it's still there.
Yes, that is correct.
It is not there. They had the G20 or the G7 summits. Nobody could connect on anything. They can't get a business flow. They can't. No one can agree.
Yeah, they can't model anything to agree. Yeah, no. Yeah, the agreement frame is non-existent there. So hang on just everybody. We're going to take a quick break. This is James Martinez back with Bob Neveritt. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. We'll take a quick break. We'll be back right after this. Is there a time for keeping your head down, for getting on with your day? Is there a time for cold lipstick, a time for cutting hair? Is there a time for high street shopping, to find the right dress to wear? Here she comes. Heads turn around, here she comes.
Hi, my name's Jack, and I'm an avid listener of Cash Flow with James Martinez. The global financial crisis is changing the world as we know it. If you've struggled for years trying to resolve your alleged credit card debt, I want you now to imagine your own personal financial freedom. The famous philosopher Lao Tzu once said, "A journey of 1,000 miles begins with one step." Take your first step in a new direction and notice how good it feels. Remember, life gets better when you're headed in a new direction, and your new direction is freedom from credit card debt. Please call 888-213-7655. That's 888-213-7655.
Psychic Source is America's most trusted psychic network. Celebrating 20 years in business in 2009, Psychic Source is also the oldest. At Psychic Source, they are proud of being the oldest and most respected psychic service available. The quality of their service is something they take seriously. Click on any of the Psychic Source web banners and get started today. You can find their banner right on the Achieve Radio homepage. Or just give them a call, toll-free, 866-907-3682, 866-907-3682. Click or call today and join America's oldest and most respected psychic network, 866-907-3682.
You may have seen the question in Parade magazine about it. MSN made it one of the top five in an article they wrote about it. And journalists around the world are asking, whatever happened to them? What is it that's bringing up all this attention? Well, it's manners, the need for good manners. Publishers Barbara Ross and Nicholas Beatty have brought the quintessential guide to manners for children back into print with their Goop series. You know the Goops? The Goops, they lick their fingers. The Goops, they lick their knives. These wonderful books, originally written by Gillette Burgess over 100 years ago, are now available for a new generation to enjoy and to learn from. Children the world over have loved these classic poems, and now you can own them to share with your children and grandchildren, nieces and nephews. Just go to www.thegoops.com to see the delightful Goops characters, a sample of the whimsical poems that help teach kids good manners by how not to be a Goop, and all the Goops Unlimited books now available. Manners, what a difference they can make. Click on www.thegoops.com today.
Yeah.
and some electric guitar.